In 1994, a German archaeologist by the name of Klaus Schmidt, who you can see here, of the University of Heidelberg and eventually the German Archaeological Institute. Now, they're the people that have been working at Göbekli Tepe. He got there in 1994, surveyed the place, and realised that there was something incredible here, because he realised that these carved pieces of stone, some of them were as much as 12,000 years old. And one quote, which I love, within the first minute, I knew that if I didn't walk away immediately, I would be here for the rest of my life. And that's indeed what seems to be happening, because they started to uncover the hillside and started to reveal all these incredible T-shaped pillars, which were carved, as you can see, and they started putting it all together. And they realised that they were uncovering the oldest stone temples in the world. Here is a reconstruction of what three of them look like, but obviously you can see that they are putting in circles for the others, and I'll come on to how many and how far this extends shortly. But I mean, what we're talking about here are a series of what we would call stone circles, but the slight difference with those from the megalithic world is that these stone circles, the stones are radiating out like spokes of a wheel from a centre position. They're more complicated. All of the pillars themselves are actually carved and ornated in a manner which I'll show you now. Now, just from the point of a reality check on where all this is occurring, it's here. There's the Mediterranean on the left. There's Turkey there, Syria, Iraq, Iran, Armenia. And it's basically when all of these countries come together, as I say, in southeast Turkey, somewhere which is very special to human evolution, as you'll see. There's some important statements here. Firstly, we're talking about a period of 12,000 years ago for the construction of Göbekli Tepe. People who were not known for coming together and constructing monuments in any way, shape or form. And what these people were creating was some kind of religious stone complex for purposes which hopefully will become apparent. But let's point out that ideally there was nothing like this existing in the world previous to this time. Nothing at all. And yet suddenly this comes out of nowhere. And the actual organisation involved with this would have been immense, because of the hundreds and hundreds of T-shaped pillars that they've uncovered so far, most of them are probably about 10 to 20 tonnes apiece, but the largest ones are between 40 to 60 tonnes in estimation. Now, these would have had to have been designed, carved and removed from quarries which were up to a couple of kilometres away from this position and brought to this site. And that would have involved some kind of social structure that is beyond our current understanding of hunter-gatherer societies. And it's pretty obvious that somebody was behind all of this. But you can see here, right in the centre, this huge, great monolith, carved monolith. It's got a fox on the side of it. And originally, this would have been anything up to, as I say, between 40 and 60 tonnes apiece at its full size. And the larger ones in the centre are believed to have supported roofs, because these were almost certainly subsurface. In other words, they were roofed over and partly created, sunk into the side of the hillside itself. Here, this gives you an impression of the extent of it. And this goes on for some distance and covers an entire hillside. And according to Klaus Schmidt, and I'll be quoting from him a lot, it involved an elite class of religious leaders or shamans creating a hierarchical system and even the earliest slavery of dozens of people to fashion and move each stone over an extremely long period of time. And the other important thing here is that at the end of Göbekli Tepe, the site was not just abandoned or destroyed, it was deliberately covered up. And It's for this reason that the stones are so well preserved, because somebody came along and they just covered up. Why exactly they would have done that is a matter of debate. But that took place around 8,000 BC. So it was up and running for as much as 4,000 years. It's a hell of a long time. And let's put some context into this. Göbekli Tepe is 7,000 years older than Stonehenge. And Göbekli Tepe is almost certainly its ancestor. The oldest accepted stone circle is unquestionably that which is going on at Göbekli Tepe. So that's 7,000 years older than that. 4,000 years older than Karahunj stone circle complex in Armenia, which is in the neighbouring country, which is dated to around 5,700 BC and has recently been established to be aligned to the constellation of Cygnus and thus the Milky Way. And you can see the difference in the style from Göbekli Tepe, the carved pillars, to obviously the erection of these carved, unhewn stones here. But that's something we'll come on to. 7,500 years older than the pyramids of Egypt. Now, people that say that the Egyptians didn't have enough time to learn the skills and technology of stonework and all the rest of it, just think of the fact that Göbekli Tepe was 7,500 years earlier than this, and 5,000 years older than the Sumerian and Akkadian civilizations of the Fertile Crescent that really established themselves around 5,000 BC. So that's the sort of time frame that we're talking here. Now, these stones are incredibly beautifully carved. As you can see just from this example, the way that the fronts, the sides, the tops of them carry a variety of different animals. In this case, we can see what appear to be herons. There are arachnids there. I'll show you this stone closer a little later on. There are serpents crawling all the way around the side of this stone. There's an incredible depth of depiction of all the different animals. You know, here you can see various other animals. There is vultures here. Again, something like herons. This is probably something like, well, I don't know, it could be a fox, could be a gazelle, something like that. Here's a boar stroke pig. And the actual types of animals are essentially this: bovines, foxes, gazelles, aurochs, lizards, canines, pigs, arachnids, insects, reptiles, snakes, lions, flightless birds, waterfowl, vultures.